1 diabetes, called T1D, is an autoimmune disorder. There is nothing you can do to prevent it and nothing you can do to get rid of it. And this is the reality for more than 200,000 kids in the U.S. Katie Kraft has T1D, and she spends her life and career as a child life specialist helping to make kids' lives with T1D better. So you understand what kids are dealing with.
Yeah, I was diagnosed at age 12. And I think diabetes is really overwhelming at the beginning when you don't know anything about it and you hear about this new life-changing thing you're taking on. So I definitely identify with our families just learning this information out of the blue and trying to figure out what to do next and how to integrate that into your life.
Yeah, and it's overwhelming for the kids. I'm sure it's overwhelming for the parents. So tell us what you do now. What is a child life specialist?
Sure. So a child life specialist is somebody that usually works in a children's hospital, and we wear a lot of different hats in the hospital, but at the end of the day, we're really there to support coping. That takes lots of different forms, whether it's educating a child about a new procedure that's coming up or being there with them during a really scary time. We also do new diagnosis education. Mm-hmm. So I do specifically work with our type 1 patients often. You can imagine that adjusting to needles in the hospital is terrifying. No kid wants to make themselves bleed or take injections.
Right.
So how do you help them become familiar with something like that? We use a lot of play and a lot of art to get kids more familiar with diabetes equipment.
Yeah, let's talk about the art, because you have worked art into this program in some very interesting ways. I know we have some video where kids are actually using, I guess it would be the needles themselves as part of a shot, to paint. God, this is absolutely fascinating. Tell
us
about this.
Really incredible, just beautiful, expressive works. But we have, paint inside of real insulin bottles, and they can practice drawing up the insulin with real needles, and then they're injecting paper before they're having to practice injecting on their own bodies. It's a really neat way. At the beginning of the activity, most of our kids are pretty scared to even touch the needle or get started, and by the end, they're just, lit up, and they're very comfortable. They're developing the dexterity they're going to need to take care of their bodies, and they really feel proud of their skills that they learned during syringe art. And it's amazing the transformation to watch them go back to the room and show mom and dad, like, look what I made, and like, I want to help you draw up my next shot. And it's really meaningful.
That's
to
an
me
amazing
to
thing.
See the transformation.
And I would think that's something even adults could benefit from.
Yeah. Absolutely. Needles are scary to everybody.
Yeah. Right.
I don't know anybody that likes needles, actually.
No, I would agree with that. And before we talk about camps, just because I know we kind of brushed over T1D or type 1 diabetes, mm-hmm. help people understand a little bit about the disease, because it's not diabetes you get because you eat poorly. It's not diabetes because you're fat. It's not, people tend to lump it all together. Tell us what you can in your words about type 1 diabetes.
Sure. Type 1 diabetes is different because it is an autoimmune disorder. So it's actually your own body, your own immune system attacking those cells that create insulin in the body. So type 1 diabetics don't produce any insulin at all. So it's a complete balancing act between what you eat and how much insulin you take. It's a very dangerous, very touchy disease. If you take too little insulin, you can become very sick. Lives can be lost. If you take too much insulin, you can become very sick and lives can be lost. So it really is this fine balance. And as soon as you know that you have diabetes, all of a sudden you're a mathematician. You're doing complex equations to figure out how much insulin to take. You're your own pharmacist advocating for medications.
It's
you're
amazing.
Working with insurance companies. You're actually administering insulin. Parents have to learn how to inject their kids, or kids have to learn how to check their blood sugars themselves. So very hands-on. Families are just plunged into this medical world that they were never a part of before. So there's a lot they have to learn very quickly.
And it doesn't go away. It's a balancing act you have forever. So another thing that you do as a child life specialist is you help kids and families meet other people who are dealing with this. Tell us about the concept of camp and why that's so important.
Yeah, it's so important. I think one of the best things about having diabetes is being part of the community. It's such an amazing, amazing community to be their people. People know what it's like. They understand. They're ready to share. They're ready to help. And I think that you can learn so many tips and tricks from others. For our kids to have the normalcy of watching other kids checking their blood sugar, watching role models also taking injections, they're learning life skills. They're learning more about their bodies in that process. And I feel like those connections of understanding really support people emotionally. This is a very emotional disease, the burden of the day-to-day management.
I can imagine
how you could burn out, and having that support system is really, really important to your physical health and also to your emotional
and
health.
And also for parents. I mean, I can barely get my kids to brush their teeth. I mean, seriously, if I had to worry about them managing a life or death situation, when you send a kid to college, you're sending all of that responsibility with them as well. I mean, it's really, it's absolutely overwhelming when you think about it. Let's talk about JDRF, the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation.
Yeah.
What kind of advancement advances has JDRF been able to do to make coping with type 1 diabetes a little easier?
It's so exciting. What an exciting time to be living with diabetes, if you can imagine that. My nurse practitioner growing up didn't even have the ability to check her blood sugar. They had to use the same needles. They had to sharpen their needles.
Oh my God. They had glass needles.
They had to boil to sterilize. So we have come so far. I'm actually wearing a insulin pump, and it is attached to my body, and it gives me insulin 24 hours a day.
Oh wow!
And I'm gonna go on a new pump next week that JDRF actually helped fund, and it talks to a glucose sensor that you can insert under the skin, and they talk to each other. And it's the very first iteration of the artificial pancreas, and it makes some independent decisions, which has never happened before.
Wow.
So we've come so far, and there's so far to go, and that's why we're so excited about the gala and raising money for JDRF.
Exactly. And so JDRF, of course, is the organization that provides the research, the funding, and everything to make a difference for everybody who is having the life experience of living with T1D. It's a very, very neat story and organization. And Katie is the guest speaker, and I can tell after talking to her, she's going to do amazing, very inspirational. The JDRF Gala is Saturday night. It is called Cure Ribbian Dreams. They are such a great group. I was honored to be there last year. For more information about T1D, you can go to the JDRF website. Katie, thank you so much.
Thanks for having
me. Great to meet you. Coming up next, another season opener, and this time it's from West Coast Black Theater. Stay with us.